Firstborn Ministry, bringing the infallible Word of God to the world.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We give God the praise and the glory, and we honor Him and all fathers. Your word to go forth, your spoken word, O God. May you anoint it with power, Almighty God, that you will humble me, Lord, and you be exalted, O King of all kings. Matchless, holy, righteous, worthy God, we give you due honor, we give you high praises. Glory, glory, glory. We honor your Father, we honor you, we bless your name. And we praise you, and we give you and you alone the glory in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and God's people who agree with this will say, Amen. Amen. And amen. 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 And amen. I'd like to turn your attention this morning to 2 Samuel chapter 9. And from verses 1 to 13, the word of God bore witness about the faithfulness of a servant of his. And as I read the word of God, I began to think about the fact that so many people from time to time have been brought into a place. They have been brought into a place. Sometimes they're brought, and another time they bring themselves to certain places. A deep place. A horrible place. A place sometimes, my God, where they are not even able now to help themselves. We read in the word of God, as I said, in 2 Samuel chapter 9 from 1 to 13. And I'm going to go through the word of God quickly, just to refresh your thought. And the word said, now David said, is there still anyone who is left of the house of Saul, that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? And we all know what happened.
Yes.
Jonathan and David were buddies.
Yes.
You know, David grew up and once Saul realized that his throne was a threat, David was a threat to his throne, my God. Saul wanted to kill David. Mm-hmm. But David found favor in the son of Saul,
yes.
Jonathan.
Yes.
And they became good buddies, and they made a covenant one day.
Yes.
They
yes.
made a covenant, and you know what happened? Jonathan swore to David that, look, I will never allow my dad to do any harm to you. If I realize that he's going to kill you, I'm going to get the message out to you.
Amen.
So you can run for your life.
Amen.
And it happened that it went like that.
Yes.
And Jonathan was true to his word. He went and he told David, look, you got to get out of here because my dad is going to kill you.
Yes.
Indeed.
Yes.
And David ran for his life. So it happened that when Saul and Jonathan went up against the Philistines, and when they fought, what happened? Saul and Jonathan lost their lives, died in battle.
Yes.
My God. And as word went forth, that Saul and Jonathan died, my God, a woman who was assigned to take care of Jonathan's son, a woman was assigned. She was the nurse to Jonathan's son. And the nurse realized and heard the bad news. and she decided to take this young child, 5 years old, Mephibosheth, and to run. And she ran with him and took him down to Lo Debar. Took him down to Lo Debar. I'm just going to the scripture, you know, and to provide a framework of what took place. Amen. The nurse took the young boy down to Lo Debar. And if you know anything about Lo Debar, it's not a good place to be. Lo Debar is a desolate place, a howling wilderness, where the lowest of the Samaritan slum, who are rejected by society, they found refuge there. Lo Debar, my God, here is a grandson of a king. God himself was taken against his own will to Lo Debar, and Mephibosheth was there for a while, my God, and he was there a cripple, and dependent totally on crutches for him to move about. Undoubtedly, he must have been ridiculed and laughed at. You know how society is when they see a cripple among them, my God, this staring that comes forth from their eyes. And some might have said that, you know, his parents might have sinned. How is it that he ended up a cripple? And those who perhaps would know the background of this young boy, we might have said, my God, this grandson of a king, what is he doing down in Lo Debar? But Mephibosheth was there, my God, and he was there for a while until he grew up to be a man. I know that when you're in a specific environment, now the environment would have shaped him. And he perhaps see himself as nothing.
Yes.
The lowest of the lowest.
My Lord.
The lowest of the lowest in Lo Debar. But the word of God spoke and says that then when David, after a while, when David was king, David remembered Jonathan.
Yes.
He remembered the kindness. He remembered the love, because the word says Jonathan loved David more than his own soul, my God. And David wanted to show kindness.
Yes.
And the word of God says in 2 Samuel chapter 2, verses, I go again, 2 Samuel chapter 9. I don't want to go ahead of myself because I'm excited in the spirit. And the word says in 2 Samuel chapter 9 from verses 3, the word says, then the king said, and that's David, is there not still someone of the house of Saul to whom I may show the kindness of Almighty God? He wanted to show kindness, despite the fact that Saul wanted to kill him. But David realized that, you know, an anointed of God, my father, that he had to be careful, you know. He didn't want to go anything against what God anointed. Whomever God anointed, he's going to respect.
Amen.
The anointing of Almighty God.
Yes.
And he wanted to show kindness. And somebody said to him, there is a grandson of Saul. A grandson who lays in Lo Debar. A grandson who was brought to Lo Debar. A lame, a cripple. My God. And David said, bring him.
My Lord.
Bring him to me. Bring him to me. And they went. And when, my God, when Mephibosheth heard that he was going to be brought to the king's table, he was afraid. Because you know what? Living in Lo Debar, he has lost all his self-esteem. He wouldn't even care anything about the fact of his lineage, that he was aligned to a king, my God. And he was scared. He was trembling. But they brought him, and David says, sit at my table. Sit there and feast. Mephibosheth had a difficulty to do that. Difficulty because he said, who am I? I'm a dog. What am I doing at the king's table? My God. Mephibosheth was wonderfully blessed, not because of anything he did, but because of David's faithfulness to a covenant promise that he had made with his friend Jonathan. Likewise, believers are blessed.
Amen.
Not because of any good deeds that we have done, but on the contrary, it is because of God's abundant, unconditional love.
Yes.
And his faithfulness to the new covenant.
Amen.
Through Jesus Christ,
Amen.
His Son and our Savior.
Amen.
For by grace, you and I have been saved.
Yes.
Through faith. And that not of ourselves. It is the gift of God.
Yes.
Not of works, lest anyone should boast about it.
Hmm.
Great is the faithfulness of Almighty God.
Yes.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Hmm.
Morning by morning by morning. New mercies we experience.
Amen.
New mercies, my God.
Yes.
Mephibosheth was brought to Lodebar. He had no say in the matter. He was brought there. But there comes a time, my God, we have to look at the flip side of it.
Mm-hmm.
There are so many folks who have brought themselves to Lodebar.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So many folks.
Mm-hmm.
Folks that sometimes are God's anointed people. Living at the king's table. They once feast at the table of Almighty God. And they chose, you know, to take themselves down to Lodebar. To live in Lodebar.
Mm-hmm.
To live a life of mediocrity.
Mm-hmm.
To live a life of nothingness. To separate themselves from children of God who they're accustomed to praise God together.
Yes.
And they go right down in Lodebar.
Mm-hmm.
And when once they find themselves in Lodebar, my God, it's a problem to get themselves out.
My God.
To get yourself out of Lodebar. A land of nothingness.
Mm-hmm.
A land of slum.
Hmm.
My God. Eating from the pig's pen.
Yes.
When your father has a table spread.
My Lord.
My God. As I was reading the word of God and meditating on this sermon, the Holy Spirit brought the parable of the lost son.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He said by choice he took himself to Lodebar.
Mm-hmm.
He was at his father's house and enjoying the good things of life.
Mm-hmm.
And he decided to take himself. I want to go on my own.
Mm-hmm.
And so many of God's people do the same thing.
Yes.
You're enjoying the blessings of Almighty God. And you take yourself away from that.
Mm-hmm.
And you find yourself in a land. A land that could be called Lodebar. A land where you are there suffering.
Mm-hmm.
My God, my God, my God.
Mm-hmm.
You lay there looking, suffering, eating from the pig's pen. Hawks! When your father has so much to offer you.
Hmm.
The lost son,
mm-hmm.
after being there for a long time, realized that something is wrong with this.
Yes.
I know that God or his father must have summoned him. Said to him, what are you doing there?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you in that place?
Mm-hmm.
Come back home.
Yes.
There's no need for you to be in Lodebar. There's no need for you to be living a life of nothingness.
Hmm.
When you could be all that.
Mm-hmm.
God Almighty, the Father and Creator of all people, have summoned his people to come back home.
Mm-hmm.
To get out of Lodebar.
Mm-hmm.
He sent Jesus Christ.
Amen.
To redeem us.
Yes.
And to call us home. Yes. From Lo Debar.
Yes.
But a long time, my God, the call has been sent forth, and folks continue. They have assimilated to the life of Lo Debar. They love it there. They sometimes just lost everything that is within them. Everything that has some dignity and self-worth. They have lost it in Lo Debar. Because when Lo Debar does not do or give anything else, it just keeps you at a place of nothingness. The boy, the lost son, one day decided, look, I'm going to go back home. I hear the voice of my father saying, come out of Lo Debar. Get out of Lo Debar, my God. And as children of God, and if you are living in Lo Debar, there's a call today. You have been called out of Lo Debar. Get out of Lo Debar. You have no place there. Get out of it. It is a hole in wilderness. It is a desolate place. It is a place where the rejected of society have fun and reside. Why would you be a child of God wants to live in that kind of way? The boy got into his senses. He came to his senses one of these days. The word says in Luke 15 and from verses 11 to 24. The boy says, look, my father has hired servants.
Yes.
He is in authority.
Yes.
And here am I in Lo Debar. What am I doing here? I'm going to go home and I'm going to tell him, look, I have sinned against you, Dad. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me one of your hired servants. And I will be satisfied with that. Because when I compare the life of what your servants are living, and when I compared it with the life in Lo Debar, my God, the servant life is better than what I was enjoying in Lo Debar. But you're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. So why would we want to continue to live in Lo Debar? You have been called out of Lo Debar. Get out of it. You have no place or business there. Get out of Lo Debar, my God. The voice of Jesus Christ is calling today. He's calling today. Come back. Yes, prodigals do come home.
Amen.
They have consciously decided not to respond to the call of Jesus Christ. What would darkness have to do with light? Or what would light have to do with darkness? Darkness will always want to mingle with light. But light must know that it is set apart from darkness.
Amen.
You have folks who sometimes get into relationships unequally yoked. Even though God is speaking to them, look, if you do that, you're going to end up in Lo Debar. You're going to get there. But they decided to go. Some of them will even tell you that they have what messages from God to do it. Contrary to the word of God. The word of God says in 2 Corinthians 6 from 14 to 18, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion has light with darkness? And what accord has Christ with Baal? Or what part has a believer with an unbeliever? And what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God.
Amen.
As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk among them. I will be their God and they shall be my people. Therefore, come out from among them and be separated, says the Lord God of hosts. Do not touch what is unclean and I will receive you. Come out of Lo Debar. I'm calling you today.
Amen.
I will be a father to you, says the word. And you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord God Almighty. There's a call for God's people to get out of Lo Debar. You've been called out of Lo Debar. You are called, my God, for you to arise and shine. Don't remain in darkness. Don't remain in a state of mediocrity when you can live a life that God has designed for you before the foundations of the earth. Isaiah 60 from 1 to 2 says, arise, shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people, but the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you.
Amen.
You have been called out of Lo Debar. Lo Debar is not for God's people. Mephibosheth realized that despite the fact that he was brought there, against his own will, he had no choice in the matter. So he says, if the king calls me, I am going to get out. I'm going to come out of it, despite the fact that I've come to enjoy this kind of environment. Despite the fact that I've been living there from I was 5 years old. Lord. I'm going to get out of it. I know nothing else. But I know, my God, that at the king's table it has to be different. So I'm going to answer to this call. He got out and he went to David. So why should not God's people respond to the call? When God says, come out, you have been called out of Lo Debar. So you can no longer remain and be comfortable in there. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ Jesus. Amen. If indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together.
Amen.
We are a peculiar people.
Yes.
We are blessed people.
Yes.
We are people of the King of Kings.
Yes.
We are sons and daughters.
Amen.
Of the King of Kings.
Amen.
So our places then would not be in Lo Debar. Lo Debar is not for any child of God.
Amen.
And the call is put out today. A call for us to get out of Lo Debar.
Amen.
It is a new dawn.
Yes.
It is a new dawn. A year of 2013 is passing. And a new year will be ushered in.
My Lord.
And it is for us to make that change.
Yes.
It is for us to get out. My God, whatever has passed, let it pass with the old year. Usher in a new beginning. Get out of Lo Debar and begin afresh. Come to the King of Kings table. He is now calling that we should come. Everything is for a season, the word says. And the season of Lo Debar is finished with.
My Lord.
We ought to rejoice and to get out. Do not tarry, my God, into Lo Debar. You have been called. The Spirit of God is saying, you have to come out. and you he made alive, who were dead in trespasses and sins, in which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience, among whom also we all once conducted ourselves in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind. We were made by nature children of wrath, just as the others. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, he made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. By grace we were saved. And because of that, a new day is dawning. A new year is in sight. And it is for us to heed to the call. Amen. To get out of low, deep bar. Amen. Get out of low, deep bar while you can make it.
Yes.
The Spirit says, we have no place in it. I cannot emphasize it more. I cannot emphasize it more, because this is an urgent call.
Yes.
It is an urgent call to get out while you can.
Yes.
Low Debar is not for a child of God. If you take yourself there, he is calling you lovingly to get out. Come back home, says the Spirit of God. For he himself is our peace, who has made both one and has broken down the middle wall of separation, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, that is the law of commandments contained in ordinances, so as to create in himself one new man from the two, thus making peace, and that he might reconcile them both to God in one body through the cross, thereby putting to death the enmity. And he came and preached peace to you who were far off and to those who were near. For through him we both have access by one Spirit to the Father. Now therefore you are no longer strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, having been built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in him the whole building being fitted together grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are being built together for a dwelling place of God Almighty in the Spirit. A new year is about to be ushered in. And I think every child of God need to examine him or herself and to see whether or not you are still living in Lo Debar. To see whether or not you are still operating by the standards of Lo Debar. There's a call today. You have been called out of Lo Debar. Get out of it. Mephibosheth got out. And I would encourage every child of God to do so. While you're able to do it, while the call is still going out, come and feast at your Father's table. Come back to your God. Come back, because the call is urgent.
Yes.
Glory be to God. It's an urgent call to come back home. Get out of Lo Debar. You have no place in there. You have no place in there, says the Spirit of God. We give God the praise and the glory. And we honor him. And we worship him. And we give him high honors and power and dominion. And we pray that God's people will heed this call. That they, if they place themselves by choice in Lodebar, that they will get out. That they will respond to the call because they have been called to get out of Lodebar. God, we praise you and we honor you and we bless your holy name. We give you thanks, O God Almighty, and we worship at your footstool. We bless your name and honor you and pray, O God, that you will be the strength of your people and that you will help them, O God, to respond to this call. In the name of the Father and in the name of the Son, we give you the praise. And all God's people who have resonated in their hearts to get out of Lodebar will respond now and say, Amen and Amen.